Welcome back to another SnowRunner Truck Review. Today we're going to take a look at one of the International Trucking Company's military defense vehicles. This truck has been used in service down in the Middle East, hauling heavy cargo and even tanks, with the ability to be up-armored as well. So before we start, I ask that you please help support the channel by liking the video and subscribing to the channel as well. Alright, so without further ado, let's jump into it and check it out. The International 5000 series trucks were developed by Navistar Defense with the purpose for military contracts. The Navistar is an armored, gritty American hauler that has served faithfully. In SnowRunner, the 5000MV is a heavy, strong, durable truck with some drawbacks that might make it less appealing as seasons continue to roll out. So, before we dive into the pros and cons, let's take a look at the base stats. The Navistar 5000MV is classified as a heavy truck. It weighs 15.4 tons. In its stock configuration, it boasts a power to weight of A, a durability of A, fuel consumption B-, fuel capacity is 340 liters or 90 gallons, it comes with a stock suspension, its tires also come stock with a 44-inch highway tire, its all-wheel drive is always on, and it does not have differential locking. Alright, let's dive into the pros and cons of the Navistar 5000MV. And you know how it goes, bad news first, so coming in at downside number 1, no differential locking. To kick things off right, let's not pull any punches here with our number 1 downside. But as we find out later, the Navistar is set up to be a very capable off-road performer, but this red flag is a huge deterrent for drivers. Not having this feature doesn't show too much in the opening parts of the maps, but in the newer, harder regions that come along, this downside limits the vehicle's capabilities in deep areas. All-wheel drive is great, but without differential locking, this causes uneven power distribution to tires. With plenty of hours testing the importance of differential locking, I'm confident in saying that if the 5000MV had this feature, its overall performance would rival the elite trucks in the game. Downside number 2, fuel consumption. Out of all the possible downsides we could ever imagine, we all know that I scrutinize fuel consumption the most. But it's common knowledge that the Navistar just downright chugs fuel. It's pretty safe to say that it's up there with the International Paystar 5600 TS on economy. So folks, for this one, despite it having a large fuel tank, you're gonna have to set up those fuel stops frequently to keep this beast fed. Downside number 3, blinding smoke. For this one, some people might not think this is a downside because it's not necessarily performance limiting, but when you can't see past the constant onslaught of that black cloud that barrels out of the Navistar, this possibly could mess with driver responsiveness. The only way to see truly in the third person view is by rotating the camera to the side farther than you would have to for any other vehicle. This one is frustrating because it can lead to inadvertently hitting obstacles. I wish there were more options to control this exhaust, but I guess it is what it is. Downside number 4, versatility. I'm the type of player who looks at a vehicle and asks the question, in what ways can I use this truck? Trucks in SnowRunner are appealing by their off-road ability and usefulness. Unfortunately, the Navistar is pretty limited in this department. It only has 4 vehicle add-ons, and it cannot use some add-ons in conjunction with a spare wheel attachment, nor can it use a crane with any saddle attachment either. I won't go too far in detail, but a crane coupled with a saddle would greatly increase the vehicle's value in my eyes because I simply love this setup. Downside number 5, maneuverability. To make this one brief, its steering is actually pretty responsive, but its turning circle is so large that it cannot weave in and out of those fast changing trails like some trucks that are the same size. It's just a big lumbering military vehicle. I hope this one gets updated along with some other downsides we talked about, but let's not get our hopes up here. Downside number 6, winch. There are only 2 heavy class trucks that do not have the heavy winch, the Pacific P512PF and the Navistar. Some might not think this is a big deal, but the truck is rather heavy and not having a strong winch to go with that doesn't make the 5000 MV a good choice for rescuing larger vehicles with a medium winch. When comparing the medium winch to the heavy, there is a big difference in power. So due to that lack of winch strength, I felt this one was a downside. And finally, coming in at downside number 7, it's not as relevant in later parts of the game. As we have talked about earlier, the Navistar loses its appeal later in the game when drivers are unlocking some of the elite trucks that basically can just do it all. Out of all the downsides we have covered, if it had differential locking, better fuel economy, less vision impairing smoke, and a few more add-ons, this truck would be on par with some of those easy mode Russian trucks. So folks, we know that the Navistar has some huge weaknesses to overcome, but it does also have a lot of strengths as well. Here are the pros for the Navistar 5000 MV. Coming in at upside number 1, power and all-wheel drive. To start the pros list off right, let's start out with an exclusive engine that only the Navistar can equip. Then, let's add that its power is in the top 5 engines in the game currently. Yes, it does not have differential locking, but take this power, all-wheel drive, and our upcoming items on this list, and it will show that the Navistar is a capable truck. Upside number 2, weight. Even though the Navistar is one of the lighter, heavy-class trucks, it would be one of the heaviest in the off-road category if reclassed. With comparable weight to some of the great, balanced, notable off-roaders, and knowledge of how weight contributes to off-road grip, the 5000 MV excels over a lot of other trucks. Upside number 3, tires and durability. Normally, I would say 50 inches is the standard of a large tire, but hey, 49 inches is pretty good as well. The Navistar cannot equip mud tires, but it can equip the heavy set OHD loadout, which is still pretty good in comparison. Also, the 5000 MV being a military vehicle has some really good damage tolerances. In fact, it has the highest engine damage tolerance in the game. I have to say, it's pretty nice knowing that your truck can take a beating, and lately, SnowRunner has been beating trucks down pretty badly. Upside number 4, fuel capacity. To be brief, its fuel economy is rather scary, but at least it has a large fuel tank to counter that fuel burn somewhat. For the life of me, I don't know why American trucks are punished with lacking tire options and fuel burn issues. I wish they would just give American trucks better economy and tire options as well, but let's see if that happens. Upside number 5, ground clearance. With the Ray suspension kit, the Navistar sits pretty high, which we know mitigates ground resistance. But one thing I must say is that its fuel tanks might get caught up on some obstacles here and there. Overall, I think it's better than the average, so I felt this one should go on the list. Upside number 6, winch connections. Something the 5000 MV has that's super unique is its winch attachment points. Despite having a poor winch for its class, the Navistar has normal attachment points, but unlike most vehicles, it has spots for attachment on its roof. This might not seem like an upside, but rolling this vehicle back over is so much easier than the standard winch spots on other vehicles. That location can be used for other things as well when the vehicle is still on its wheels, but regardless, this one is pretty neat. Upside number 7. All exclusive upgrades are unlocked. All the upsides we spoke of make the Navistar a capable, interesting truck, but all of its exclusive upgrades are unlocked at driver level 1. Essentially, you can have a fully upgraded Navistar if you can pay for its pricey upgrades. And this leads me to our 8th and final upside on the list. It's a good truck for early game. Looking back over the 5000 MV's upsides, it's pretty clear and evident that this truck would be great for early game drivers to use. It might lose its luster later on when the elite trucks start to come along, but this truck can carry you through some of the nasty first parts of the game for sure. Alright, so moving on to my personal ratings for this vehicle. For power, I gave it a 5 because it's one of the most powerful engines in the game that's exclusive to the Navistar. For terrain navigation, a rating of 4. If the 5000 MV had differential locking, this rating might have been higher. Being able to completely upgrade this vehicle at the start of the game merits a 5 for sure. For aesthetics, it's one of my favorite looking trucks in the game. Stability is actually better than I thought, but it wasn't a highlight. However, I do feel it's pretty stable in a lot of scenarios. A very large fuel tank, but some of the worst fuel consumption I've seen merits this truck a rating of 2. In short, it doesn't have much utility, but a few add-ons, and most add-ons cannot be used in conjunction, so for this one, a rating of 1. Heavy weight, awesome power, always on all-wheel drive makes the Navistar pretty good with grip. Again, if it had always on differential locking, this rating would be higher. So in conclusion, the Navistar, in my opinion, is a powerhouse that has just a few pieces missing to make it stand with those elite Russian trucks in late game. I really don't know why American trucks are punished with small fuel tanks, poor tire options, and crazy fuel consumption rates. The 5000 MV actually has a good set of tires, but most North American trucks don't have good tire options. The total lack of differential locking is for sure the biggest downside. Differential locking is so important in those deep areas, and to be honest, lighter areas in SnowRunner aren't around much lately. I believe this is the reason the Navistar is put on the shelf in later parts of the game. Its story is somewhat similar to the BM17. Another North American truck with hamstrung performance due to lack of differential locking. The Navistar was a really popular truck when the game first came out, but as time passed, players moved on to more versatile, full package type trucks. If the developers want to make the North American trucks competitive, this video's conclusion is a good place for ideas. In truth, I like the Navistar so much that just to review the truck, I bought the game on Steam and transferred my save file from Epic Games to Steam just to play it. I believe it's a durable, strong, hard-working truck that can get the job done. If the Navistar was never changed, I would just deal with its smoky, fuel-guzzling nature because the truck feels so strong, yet somehow I still think it's an underdog, of which I still root for. So in closing, the 5000 MV is still a great option for drivers to use in later parts of the game. You just need to have some patience and good planning. Try it out and let me know what you think. I hope this review gave you a fresh, new perspective of the Navistar 5000 MV. Please smash the like button. Definitely share this video with someone who is struggling with the game and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you don't miss any future content. Hope y'all have a wonderful day. God bless and stay upright.